Today's parable may seem strange to us, but to the people of Jesus' time, it was a perfectly recognizable setting, with the bridegroom going away, the 10 maidens waiting for the bridegroom to return, and then the unexpected return of the bridegroom. William Barclay, who writes a commentary on the books of the Bible, describes the custom this way. A prominent doctor of theology was approaching the gates of a Galilean town, and he caught sight of 10 maidens, gaily clad and playing some kind of musical instrument, as they danced along the road in front of his car. When he asked what they were doing, a man told him that they were going to keep the bride company until her bridegroom arrived. So he asked if there was any chance of seeing the wedding, and was told that it might be tonight, might be tomorrow night, it might be a fortnight away. Nobody ever knows for certain. Then he went on to explain that one of the great things to do at a middle-class wedding in Palestine was to catch the bridal party napping. So the bridegroom comes unexpectedly, and sometimes in the middle of the night. He is required to send a man along the street to shout, "Behold, the bridegroom is coming." But that could happen at any time. So the bridal party has to be ready to meet him at any time, whenever he chooses to come. Also part of the custom is that once the bridegroom has arrived and the door has been shut, latecomers to the wedding are not allowed. The parable is taken from an actual slice of life in the Jewish communities of those times. Yet for us, this parable has broader meaning and warning. It points out to us that there are certain things that cannot be obtained at the last minute. We cannot and do not know when Jesus will come again. It has been 2,000 years, and the world is still waiting for his second appearance. For example, it's too late for a student to study once the day of the exam has arrived. Although many will put off the studying until the last minute for sure. It is too late for a person to acquire a skill when they have to perform the task immediately. It's too late, too easy to put off preparing ourselves for Jesus' coming when the floodwaters are lapping at the doorstep. In the light of the tragedy in the South Texas area from Hurricane Harvey, Mary and I were discussing what things we would take with us if we had to evacuate at a moment's notice. And it was revealing how little has lasting meaning to us when we are out of time. A harbinger of what truly matters. Another warning from this parable is that there are certain things which cannot be borrowed. We cannot borrow a relationship with God from anyone else. That is something we have to develop here and now and over time. We cannot borrow a virtuous character. We have to be clothed with it daily. We cannot borrow our spirituality from others. We cannot slide into heaven on someone else's coattails. We get in on our own merit and with acceptance of God's freely given grace and mercy. This is the will of God, our holiness. Foolish or wise in the eyes of God? That is the question